going on everyone? Nostalgia925 coming at you with another Explaining Digimon episode. This one is going to be very different than the usual one because we are going to be talking about a recent addition to the Digimon roster. I'm talking about Pulsemon, a Digimon that, as Marine Solar said in the Nostalgia925 community page, looks like a fusion between Vemon and the Pokemon Pikachu, and also believe so when looking at its appearance and also its attacks, who are all electric based. Very Pikachu-like. We will get to the details in a moment. Let us first travel towards the creation of this new addition. As has been tweeted in Digimon Tweets, Pulsemon was designed by Fumiya Kobayashi. The inspiration for the design is that of a boy who loves doing sports, who loves physical activities. That is why it wears sneakers, to look more like an active boy. To emphasize its connection with humans, heart and wave-like shapes were added to its design. So, speaking in general, Pulsemon is a Digimon that matches the image of sportiness and wearability. Now, why the connection with humans? You see, Pulsemon is meant to be the mascot of the Digimon Vital Bracelet, a fitness tracker tracking the steps and heart rate of its users where they will raise their digital monsters through walking, running, and just about any other form of physical activity. I think it would be very interesting for me to buy it, as I myself do love to run and train in my spare time just to stay in shape, and I would say especially now with the virus at our doorstep, making many people stay inside and sometimes lose shape. A little side note, because in this video we are going to be talking about Pulsemon, I am aware that I cannot really be doing justice to the bracelet even though I really like it, so if you want me to give my opinion on it, make sure to let me know in the comment section. There is a very important trivia, a piece of information of little importance but still one who deserves to be mentioned. You see, each model of the tracker bracelet come with a Digimon identified memory card, also simply called DIM card. Each card contains a different Digimon. To give an example, you have a card showing Gabumon, Agumon, XVmon, etc. Now, what is the trivia? In a Digimon News Navigation interview with Ms. Chiaki Matsuzawa and Mr. Iwai of Haraishi, it has been stated that originally they were only going to use new Digimon for the fitness tracker, but it changed their mind after realizing that there are more than 1,000 Digimon already in existence. And I would stop by the number 1,000 for a moment, because as we are trying to explore most, if not all, Digimon on this channel, I do want to express how amazed I am about that number. They did not specify whether that number included the Apmon or the other creatures who are not named Digimon but still reside in the Digimon universe. They said 1,000 Digimon. This would mean that, when considering all 1,000 Digimon and other aspects that are worthy of being discussed and studied, like the human characters or some random questions like why do angel Digimon wear masks, I could see myself make over 1,000 videos about the Digimon franchise. It does make me happy, because there are yet so many aspects that need to be explored, and it also appears that new Digimon keep on coming, meaning that that world, that universe, is growing bigger and bigger. So I'm very excited to keep on exploring every aspect one by one. Now, Pulsemon is of the Beastman Digimon type, meaning it is of the same type as Liumon, who we discussed in explaining a Liumon Digivolution 9 video. Just for your information, there are various beast types in the Digimon universe, who may or may not be related to one another like do the Dramon species, who are all related to Dracomon, the progenitor of all Dramon type. When it comes to beasts, there is a distinction that can be made between the Beastman Digimon, like Pulsemon, the Beast Digimon, the Holy Beast Digimon, the Demon Beast Digimon, and the Ancient Beast Digimon. Pulsemon is a Digimon that digivolved under the influence of heartbeat waveform data stored in hospitals and gyms, showing once more how connected the Digimon universe is to the real world. Many aspects of the planet are directly and indirectly influencing the Digimon universe, despite that statement that Digimon are not born because computers were created. For more on that, check out the description box. When it comes to the personality of Pulsemon, we are being told that it treats anyone without discrimination, which I think is very interesting, especially when we put that personality trait into perspective by looking at other rookies, like let us say Dracomon, who does discriminate, who shows its gentle side only to those it has recognized. When it comes to the skills, it is said that Paulsmon is a cunning fighter who battles by capitalizing on its natural agility and moving around in the shape of a lightning bolt. It can ram into its enemies at lightning speed or can discharge electricity generated within its body from its fringe. So, to summarize, Paulsmon is a rookie Digimon that has great mobility and is very agile, and can use electricity to enhance its offensive arsenal. We will see in a moment how these characteristics will be carried over to its champion forms. Let me show you a quote concerning Paulsmon. I quote, "In addition, many Digimon that are influenced by the vital data of others, like Paulsmon, improving their physical abilities and digivolving, have been discovered." I admit to be a little bit confused with the sentence. I assume that it is trying to tell that Digimon who are influenced by the vital data of other Digimon, like Paulsmon, that their physical abilities will improve and that they might digivolve or digivolve quicker. Now the truth is that it is not necessarily a new discovery, as Gabumon is known to have been influenced by the data of Garurumon to digivolve. I talked about it plenty of times in this channel, like in the one video where we talked about Gabumon's digivolution potential. A video where we claimed that Gabumon could potentially digivolve in whoever it wants depending on the data it manages to gather. Kabuterimon, Greymon, Ikakumon, Gabumon could potentially digivolve into those because it is said that Gabumon created the pelt it is wearing by gathering the data which Garurumon leaves behind. This means that Garurumon, according to my theory, is not Gabumon's true champion form and that both are not connected. After all, Gabumon is a reptile Digimon, just like Agumon or Gilmon, who suddenly digivolved into the animal Digimon Garurumon. Normally, it is a bit unlikely to see a reptile-type Digimon suddenly digivolve into an animal-type Digimon. That is why I even believe that Gabumon's true champion might be Cyclonemon. For more on that, make sure to check out the videos in the description box. But the point I am trying to make, in case I did not yet make it is not new to see Digimon being influenced by the data of another Digimon to develop. In fact, there are some Digimon who exist because of the data of other Digimon. It is important to remember that. I want you guys to take a look at this picture. Paulsmon has 4 confirmed champions. All 4 have their own reason for being, which we are going to explore in a moment. We will not discuss the ultimate nor mega forms, as not all of them are revealed. Once we get more, we will get back to it. Now, what you have to understand about Paulsmon is that there are 2 ways to look at it. It has 2 stories, let me say it like that. Remember the fitness tracker I talked about minutes ago? Those who are going to buy it are basically going to become Digidestined, because the tracker almost works similar to a Digicrest. I've yet to explain in details what a Digicrest is all about, but suffice it to say that when the Digidestined exhibits the trait of his or her crest, which can be via a strong gesture or act of love, courage, knowledge, etc., depending on which one you get, the crest will glow and its power will be released to enable their Digimon partners to digivolve. When procuring yourself with a Digimon fitness tracker, you will get a Digimon identified memory card, which will contain a Digimon. Depending on the one you get, you will have Paulsmon. Now, depending on how you are training or if you are training, your Paulsmon will get the energy to digivolve into one of its champion forms. Let me refer to the comment of Astro Menusix, who wrote in the Nostalgia Night 5 community page, the following was said. Its name is Paulsmon since this device measures your pulse and it will influence your partner's digivolution route. If you do a lot of exercise and move a lot, it will probably evolve into Bulkmon, but if you are lazy and don't move a lot, it will probably evolve into Namekimon, which is based on a sloth. My Dino wrote the following, here are what each of the champion forms are based on. Bulkmon muscle building, Exeromon dancing, Namekimon laziness, Runamon running. And so, just like with a Digicrest, you can make your Paulsmon digivolve into one of these 4 depending on your action. But that is just one story explaining how these champions come to be. It will be your story, once you will get one of these trackers and use them in a particular way to make one of the 4 champion manifests. Now, what you have to know is that each of these champion forms have their own personal story, which we will take a look at right now. Starting with Bulkmon, a Dragonman Digimon, the same type as War Greymon. Its name comes from bulking, which is a process used to gain weight while preserving as much muscular mass as possible, commonly used in bodybuilding. This is making Bulkmon sort of like the Hulk or the Broly of the 4 champion, as it came to be because of the data of a body composition monitor that measures muscle mass. And you see, when looking at its appearance and its well-developed body, we shouldn't be surprised that it gained a bellicose personality, meaning a personality showing a willingness to fight or demonstrate aggressiveness. It gained a lot of raw power, and that became its strength. Its power is said to be top class even among champion Digimon, which does make me curious to see it face a V-Dramon, said to be able to exhibit power that is uncommon even among champions. What is all the more interesting about Bulkmon is that despite its larger body and heavy muscles, it still has extremely high reaction speed and can overwhelm its enemies with tremendous power, and even speed. So, just by its appearance, you know it is dangerous in close range, and yet it still has its trademark electric attacks to deal with opponents that refuse to come closer, terrifying in close range with long range tools. Bulkmon can be seen as a hard worker of the 4 champions. It works hard and trains when it is not eating or sleeping. Among the 4 champions, the opposing Digimon to Bulkmon would be Namakimon, a puppet Digimon, with a name referring to Namakimono, which is Japanese for a sloth, or it can be used to simply label someone as lazy. Namakimon, as opposed to Bulkmon, is a Digimon that has ended up only finding joy in life from eating and sleeping. It dislikes strenuous exercises. Because of this laziness, Namakimon had its combat instincts erased as a Digimon and can't even summon electricity anymore. It does not have that heavy alertness and survival instinct you would see other Digimon have. No, it became lazy, loves to eat and sleep, and the one way it knows to assure its survival is to live in elevated areas such as on treetops so that no one can approach it. And by the way, just for your information, a sloth sleeps 15 to 18 hours a day, so we can assume that Namakimon does the same. Because the Digimon has arms used to grasp onto tree branches, it became able to use its long, well-developed tongue skillfully as a third arm. A little bit like the Pokemon Lickitung, who can paralyze its prey with a lick from its long tongue. And that is also what Namakimon does. It can use its tongue, which secretes a numbing venom, to lick the enemy. It does, however, rarely get the chance to use it. My personal opinion, I've always been a fan of poison, either in games or even in real life. I kind of like studying the effects it has. I know it may sound creepy, but still, there's the venom of snakes, the venom of scorpions, all very lethal depending on who it is used on. That is why I really hope that Namakimon will become a prominent poison user in its future forms, just like the Fallen Angel Digimon Ragelmon. I really want poisonous Digimon to become more present, so I will be rooting for that. Now, as I said, Namakimon loves heights. It loves to live on high trees. Another one of Pulsemon's champions also loves heights. I'm talking about the insect Digimon Exuremon. It loves to live in high mountainous regions. That is probably because it digivolved from yoga lesson data, and a basic requirement for yoga is that you should find yourself in a quiet area or a place where noise is reduced. And what better place than doing yoga on a mountain? Exuremon's name comes from exercise, as it is a Digimon who does a lot of exercise. You see, Bulkmon is certainly the powerhouse among the four. It trains mostly to build and strengthen its muscles and raw power. Exuremon, on the other hand, has a different type of training. I would even say that it represents the brains among the four champions. After all, it has yoga data, so the emphasis would probably lie on the brain or the mind. Exuremon trained and developed its own fighting discipline, its own style of taijutsu, which adopts unique movements. On top of that, it has telepathic abilities by using its antenna as a medium, which confuses intruders. The same antenna can also be used to absorb sunlight and convert it into electrical energy within its body. And this same electrical energy can be used as a defibrillator, as Exuremon's palms can be used to act as positive and negative electrodes, delivering an electric shock. A very balanced Digimon in the figurative sense of the word as well as the literal sense of the word, because it has an excellent sense of balance in that it supports its own weight with the stinger on its rump, and its core never shakes regardless of what unnatural poses it takes. To finish, the last champion would be Runnermon, a beast Digimon. Runnermon digivolved via the data from a treadmill, already showing where the emphasis lies, especially with a name referring to running. It is a Digimon that loves to run and became so prominent in it that it became capable of running without any loss in speed, even through areas with poor footing such as mountainous areas or swamplands. What I would say the most impressive about Runamon is that its stamina is very high. It is able to continue running for long periods while maintaining its top speed the entire time. That is crazy. Runamon in my eyes would be the most natural, standard Digivolution of Pulsemon, as Pulsemon already has this natural agility and great mobility just like Runamon. Both even share similar attacks but with slight differences. Pulsemon has an attack called Elec Rush, where it rams into the enemy with all its might at lightning speed, and Runamon has an attack called Lightning Rush, where it also charges at the enemy at super speed but from their blind spots. Just like that, we took a look at all champion forms of Pulsemon. Very interesting, all four of them. Even though to me personally the best forms are Exeromon and Namakimon. Exeromon because I love how it represents balance and spiritual perfection, and Namakimon because it is lazy but can be lethal, and more importantly because it uses poison. I'm really looking forward to both their next forms. I'm only hoping that poison will remain a thing with Namakimon. The poison could even become a good message to those buying one of those Digimon Vital bracelets. It could become a message like the one Pope Francis sent to the world, claiming that laziness is a poison. When it comes to Exeromon's next forms, I would hope it becomes a bit like Shakamon, another Digimon who to me also shows or represents spiritual perfection and this higher form of being. I say so because I've always told my friends that physical training is just one part of your training. Your mind needs to also be trained just as hard as you would train your body, because it is from a strong mind that you can exert patience, cleverness, creativity, confidence, and so forth. The mind is just as important to train as your physical body. Exeromon, with its data coming from yoga, represents the mind, and so I'm hoping that while becoming an ultimate, later on mega, that the mind will still play an important role. So, to the Digimon developers, I'm really looking forward to what you guys have in mind. Now to finish, I'm going to show two interesting comments written in the community page about Pulsemon. Horier wrote the following: "The design is pretty sleek and looks somewhat similar to Gaiomon. Could very well imagine those two having a rivalry." Horier is referring to Kadutimon, which is one of Pulsemon's mega. It does not yet have a biography. Gaiomon is also known as Samodramon, a subspecies of the Greymon species. I can certainly understand why someone would put the two of them as potential rivals. I'm sure it has something to do with the sword. And so far, we have discussed quite a few very interesting mega level Digimon who have swords. Think of Taitamon, Orgamon's mega, who by the way has a sword with Skullgreymon's head. I'd like to discuss the Digimon swordsmen and ask your opinions about how you would think they would interact, which one would form alliances or rivalries. I'm sure it would be very interesting. And last comment is the one of Millennium Man, who wrote the following: "It's more like an Appmon." I brought up this message because Millennium Man was not the only one claiming that Pulsemon resembles an Appmon. I have yet to explore the Appmon universe for myself because I'm really lacking in information. So the truth is I can't really tell how you guys see Pulsemon more as an Appmon. That is why I'm asking you to be expressive and write down in the comment section how and why you believe it looks more like an Appmon. Do it. Do it. Do it now. Hey guys, this is the end of the video. This is the end of this particular Explaining Digimon Digivolution Line video. We will get back to Pulsemon once more is revealed. In the meanwhile, I would suggest that you guys express yourselves in the comment section and talk about what you have seen so far. Do you enjoy Pulsemon and its champions? What are your wishes for its ultimate and mega forms? How do you think they would fit in the Digimon universe? What rivalry would they have? Which role might they play? Again, be expressive and let loose in the comment section. And by the way, all articles and videos I've been referring to or used as sources are in the description box, that way you can consult them. Make sure to subscribe for more Digimon, and actually more Appmon. If there are 1,000 Digimon already made, then there is bound to be more Digimon videos here on this channel. That is why you have to make sure we are all on the same boat. So again, make sure to subscribe and drop a like. And if you are new, know that all my Digimon related videos are placed in particular playlists. That way you can catch up on newer and older videos.